Hey there, everybody. Welcome to Belmont Boy and the first episode of Requiem Reborn. I really can't tell you guys how excited I am to finally be playing this for you. I've been working on it for a really long time, and it's just honestly, I can't even believe that it's finally out. I'm pretty giddy, if you can't tell it in my voice, because I don't actually get to play this that often. I spend so much time building and tweaking and all that other stuff that I don't actually get to play. But, you know, I'll save all that stuff. If you haven't watched the intro, I strongly recommend it, just because it'll give you a pretty good sense of what's new in the game and what to expect and the design philosophies and all that other fun stuff, if that's what you're into. But let's go ahead and just jump right in. So as you saw in the intro to this episode, we are Redguard. Our name is something. Atom. That's our name. We're a Redguard named Atom, and we got the Bandit Outlaw start, which means that we do have a bounty in whichever hold that we're in. I don't know where that is because I don't recognize this place. I'm sure we'll find out soon enough. So starting as a Bandit Outlaw has a couple advantages. For one, these people they're bandits normally, but now they're all of our friends. And they will actually fight with us in battle if it ever comes to that. You can look at this cave as like a resource. You know, you can stay warm with something like this. You can rest here, take shelter from the elements early on. It's not bad. Not a bad start, the Bandit Outlaw. The other thing that's really cool, arguably the much cooler thing, is that everything in this cave we can take. It's flagged as ours. So I think what would be smart to do is just kind of go around this cave at least for a moment and find anything useful and just kind of nab it all up. Luckily, our friends don't seem to mind, which is something that I think is kind of funny. But I guess it makes sense. I'm sure you could write a justification for it. Like, maybe I'm going on a bandit journey for the good of the whole cave, and what they don't actually know is that I'm not coming back because I'm an asshole. I don't really plan on coming back here, but we'll see how it goes. What is this place? Ooh, a dwarven shield? The other thing... okay, hold on a second. Let's see what we have. I don't know what we have right now. All. We got some fur armor, got some green apples. They're not doing so hot, they're lightly stale, but that's okay. Hide shield, we're gonna favorite that. And iron hatchet, same thing, we're gonna favorite that too. So this is gonna be our early starting equipment. Got some lock picks, got some sneaking potion, and wow, 10 potions of healing. They're faint, they're not fantastic, but that's actually a huge, huge resource. I have 3 perks to a thing. So now, this is kind of important. We're gonna go ahead and decide what sort of character we're gonna be. I think that I'm most comfortable as a one-handed... We're a red guard, and we get some pretty decent bonuses to pretty standard martial skills. So I'm going to go ahead and put some points in one-handed and marksman. I think those are my 2 favorite trees. They're definitely what I'm most familiar with. What's important to remember is that there's a lot of stuff changed in this game, but everything's built around Requiem. So if you know Requiem, generally speaking, your expertise will apply to this game. Also, I'm not fantastic at Requiem. I'm okay, but there's a lot about it that I don't know. So if you are a Requiem veteran, please, please chime in if you see that I'm doing something, you know, inefficiently, or if you have tips and tricks and everything like that, I would greatly appreciate it. First thing we're going to do is get basic ranged combat training. That's pretty necessary. If you don't know Requiem very well, if you're just like a, you know, general Skyrim player, a huge change in Requiem is that you really need to skill your skill trees, perk your skill trees rather, if you want to be proficient. If you don't have perks, you know what? No, I'm going to go ahead and put this in light armor. If you don't have perks in the equipment that you're trying to use, you will use it very inefficiently. It's just generally a bad time if you don't have proper skills and perks, which I really do enjoy. Block or light armor? I'm going to go with block for now. Hopefully it doesn't come back to bite us. All right, so there we go. There's our first 3 perks distributed. Let's go ahead and clear out this cave. This dwarven shield will be nice. I'm going to hold on to it for now, but as a new character, one of the things we're going to have to manage is, oh, sweet. I got some water. Work? What?
Of course not. Dogs I can train, but a half-starved wolf, not a chance.
Right. Lucky if it doesn't rip our throats out.
Yeah, you're probably right about that. What was I saying? One of the things we're going to have to worry about as a very, you know, new character is carry weight. Carry weight is something you kind of have to manage throughout the whole game. But it's especially a concern as a new character. Because take a little bit of meat in case we run into some... Ooh. Just one. Just one, just in case we need it. Mead can be useful in certain situations. Wheat is very useful because we can use that to make health potions. Oops, I didn't mean to take that armor. But anyway, carry weight is something we really have to watch because it'll affect not only our movement speed and like our, you know, ability to fight, but you know, we don't have a lot of it. If you look at our inventory right now, we have what, 136 carry weight, and we've already filled up more than a third of that just by nabbing some stuff. So we'll grab what's useful, try and partition off our weight well. So get some firewood. It's not terrible. Get some kindling, just in case we need to start a fire. Oh, this goes actually deeper into the cave. All right, well, we're gonna check that out. Here's some gold. What do I have? A battle axe is what I have? A hatchet. I'm gonna go ahead and stick with the hatchet for a couple reasons. Assign that to one. Get some gold, some leather strips, not bad. Anything in the dresser? Common cap, amulet of Arcay. We'll take it. Not super great, but you know, not bad. And since this is a bandit cave, there should be a boss loot chest somewhere. So let's go ahead and see if we can find it.
I hope nobody misses that.
Oh, he saw me take it. They do kind of comment on stuff like that, which is really nice for immersion. One time, I actually also, and this is during my playtesting, I was doing a bandit start, and it threw me on Solstheim in the Dragonborn content, and I was in this like abandoned encampment. And I did what I'm kind of doing now, where I was just going around and, you know, picking stuff up that I felt like would be useful. And I heard some bandits talking like above me, because we were in like a shipwreck that they had kind of turned into a little base. And they were talking about me. One of them goes, it's like, what is he doing down there? And the other one replied, it's like, oh, I don't know. They're probably just looking for food or something. And at that moment, I was literally about to pick up like some soup and some food. It was a kind of like a cool little moment. Blackbriar Private Reserve. Man, these guys have really kind of prioritized their alcohol, because that makes sense for bandits.
Who's there? Rodolphe? That you?
Yeah.
Boss was looking for you, said he'd be up at the summit. Better not keep him waiting.
All right. Ulfur's book. He's blind. Oh, clever. Oh, I know where I am now. I recognize this dude. We're in Whiterun. Oh, actually, you know what? That's kind of a problem, because Whiterun is an area... we have a bounty right now, because we started as a bandit. And it'd be nice not to have a bounty in Whiterun, because this is an area where we really need to kind of like stick around. You know what? It might be worth it just to go ahead and turn myself in. Going to jail in ordinary Skyrim really isn't that big of a deal. It just kind of reduces your experience. Oh, that's a saber cat. Oh, it's dead. Oh, this is the entrance. Okay, well, this isn't where I want to go. I know where to go, though. But anyway, yeah, so we're in Whiterun right now. We really need to not have a bounty here, because we're going to be doing a lot of stuff in this area. And anyway, going to jail is not a big deal when you are playing vanilla Skyrim, because all it does is take away experience, and experience is relatively easy to get back. In Requiem, however, experience is extremely valuable, and going to jail can be really, really shitty. So I think the best thing to do, if we're gonna do it, would be to go now, when we don't really have any experience to like give up. Just serve our time, and then you know, call it a day and just move on. Call ourselves a reformed bandit, and just go from there. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. All right, let's go ahead and continue to clear this place out. Go this way, because I know this is towards the boss chest. In fact, here, actually, I'm gonna go ahead and just, oops, ingredients, blisterwort and wheat. There we go. So wheat is important for health potions. Health potions are very useful, as you can imagine, because they stop you from dying. Namira's rot, I think, might have damage. I'm not the best alchemist. I can't remember like a lot of the things. So as you can see here, our menus are toggleable. On the very right, what you see is durability. This is like a big feature of the game, is that your stuff can break and you have to keep it tempered, or else it will it'll break and you'll be, you know, in the worst situation, and suddenly, boom, your weapon breaks or your armor breaks and you're fucking toast. So we're gonna have to really manage that. Look at these guys. Bogamu Groshadbu. What's up, bro?
What now?
What? Take it easy. And Grerid the knife. You guys trying to train this? Wait! They trained it. It's outside the thing and it's not doing anything. I thought he said he couldn't do it. Well, dang, I was thinking about letting that wolf out and kind of letting it go to town on my bandit friends. Is that evil? Oh, you got an empty water skin. That's super useful. Boom. There we go. So that way we can fill up some water. In case we find it, which we will, because it's everywhere. Hey, bud. Gerard Aronson. I like your hats. Everyone's got the same hats. Iron Warhammer. That would be pretty nice if I were a two-handed character, but I'm not. I'm not fantastic at two-handed. Obviously, it's a little bit trickier than one-handed, I think, because you don't have a free hand. But it can be really powerful in the right hands. If you guys have ever seen Samir, please. He's another Requiem player. Ooh, Iron Orbane. Here, let's go ahead and grab our pickaxe. Wait, do we have a pickaxe? Oh, we don't have a pickaxe. Shit. Oh, well, let's see if there's one around here. Yes! There often is. But anyway, two-handed can be really, really powerful if you know how to use it, which I'm not fantastic at.
Be careful.
Shut up. Get some iron ore. This is the most exciting part of the game right here. Keep it going. Come on, no whammies. Cross our fingers for a gem. That would be nice. Oh, yeah, baby. Rough amethyst. There it is. Two gems? Was that two that I heard? Let's check it out. We got... yeah, two rough amethysts, six iron ore. Not bad. Not a bad haul. Switch back to the hatchet. I'm gonna go ahead and actually assign these to a group. Right there, and there. So now, when I hit F1, it should equip both. Yep, there we go. Alright, sweet. Anything in the basket? Sometimes the developers will hide stuff in like baskets and things like that where people aren't likely to look. It's kind of like a hallmark of Bethesda development. For a really long time, that was one of my favorite things about Morrowind, was that they would kind of hand place all different kinds of stuff for you to find and unlock. Ooh, some bows. Those who are skilled in the art of weapon craftsmanship are able to upgrade any bow to a, what was it, scoped bow. That's actually, if you guys have never used the scope bow mod, it's really amazing. In this playthrough, there are no crosshairs. That's not true. There's crosshairs when you're using spells, just because I felt like it was unfair otherwise. But when we're, you know, shooting stuff,
are you staring at?
Marksman business, we're not going to have a crosshair. So either we can get good with a regular bow, or we can put a scope on it. All right, well, here's our boss chest. Let's go ahead and see what we have. Bosmer boots. Looks like it's better than whatever we have now. An elven battle axe, not bad. We can't use it, really, but we can definitely sell it. So, I mean, hey, not a bad haul for a starting location. Huh. All right, well, let's go to jail. What do you think? You could probably just walk down. Skyrim is beautiful like this. You can just walk down cliffs. Although, I just remembered that I'm now actually playing this for you guys, for the channel, so maybe I shouldn't, because if I die, that's it. Permanent death. Yeah, you know what? I'm going back up. I don't want to risk it. It's pretty... all right, let's see. Let's see if there's an easier way down that I know. Yeah, okay, here we go. This is fine. This is no sweat. We can come down here, no problem. Ugh. Rock climbing. It's always fun. I haven't gone rock climbing in a while. Need to. Oh, got some Z-fighting over there on the shadow. That's if you guys don't know what Z-fighting is in Skyrim, it's really, really annoying. And there's really no reliable way to get rid of it. But if you look at these mountains in the distance, see as I move left and right, you see them kind of flicker a little bit? That's Z-fighting. What it means is there's kind of like overlaid textures that are both fighting to be displayed. And it can create some kind of weird graphical glitches. What's up, Ellisrim Acornstone? He's a Bosmer. Search barrel. Ooh, some salt. That's a lot of salt. Let me go ahead and take 5. Large sack, more salt. Empty crate, and a bucket. A bucket can actually be really nice to have in case we come across a well. But there's plenty of water around here, so I don't think it's going to be a problem. Search Sabercat. Here we go. Now we're talking. Get some claws. Raw meat, 16. That's a lot of meat. Sabercat eye, Sabercat heart. Just go ahead and take all this stuff. The pelts are pretty valuable. The teeth are all good. It's not easy to take down a Sabercat, so we should definitely capitalize on the fact that they did and steal all the stuff. Large sack. Sack of flour. It's kind of heavy. I'll take 2 of them. I'm already kind of... oh, I'm literally right up to the weight limit right now. Let's go ahead and see if there's anything more valuable that we can take. I can't unlock this. Even though it's I might be able to bash it. Let's see. I get it? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Flawless Emerald! Fuck yeah, that's what I'm talking about. And a potion of featherweight, which might even come in handy right now, if we want to use it. Not bad. Not a bad haul at all. This is a great place to start. Is this a... Oh, it's a ladle. Alright, let's keep it moving. Got some fish. I think we're good on food for now. Let's go ahead and eat a couple apples. I know we're going to be getting hungry pretty soon here. I'm well sated, huh? Alright, well, I mean, pretty much we have a, you know, we can do whatever we want. We really have to be careful, because pretty much everything can fucking kill us at this point. But, you know, we just gotta be cautious, and I think we'll be fine. Early game in Requiem is always one of the most dangerous parts, just because you really don't have that much means to defend yourself. And, as you can see, my stamina is already draining just from walking around, because my character sucks balls and is a newbie piece of shit. So, I think our first priority, give me some lavender. Also be on the lookout for, oh, that's loud. Oh boy, look at all those fish. All right, let's get moving. So I don't know how large our bounty is. Yep, he's coming right after me. What's up, baby? Stop right there. All right, let's go.
We're going to rot to the Dragon's Reach dungeon.
Alright, I'm sorry. I know. Blast it! I'm definitely gonna have to serve my time. Oh my god, there's a dead bandit! Jesus, guy. Health. So it takes a little, like a second for their names to update. But usually it's not too bad. So I could sneak out of here if I knew how to pick locks, which I don't. Nor would I actually want to sneak out, because that's pretty much a guaranteed death, I think. Hey, buddy. These are actually pretty nice jail cells. Or at least that one is. Oh, maybe that's not a jail cell at all. Where's he going? I don't know if I want to know what's going on in that cell. Alright, well, shit. What time is it right now? All my stuff is gone. I guess let's just serve our time. Alright, we are a free man. I feel like we really turned over a new leaf after our life of crime. It looks like we are very hungry, thirsty, and tired. Which I guess is to be expected after a stint in jail. We have some food, so we can rectify that a little bit. Don't want to eat that raw meat. That would be not a great idea. Okay, in fact, here. Let's just go ahead and eat all those apples. I can drink. You know what? This water is probably clean, right? I can drink out of there. And luckily, with all the stuff that we nabbed from that bandit encampment, we are going to have more than enough for a night's stay at the inn, which will be good. Maybe we'll do some stuff in Whiterun. That would be fun. Alright, we just filled up our water, and can I just take a drink too? There we go. And another drink. One more. There it is. Alright. What is this over here? Oh, the water skin is now- Hey, puppy! How you doing? Hey. Adorable. Let's see, that water skin put me just over the limit. Let's go ahead and drop a Nordmead. Can I walk? Nope. Not enough. Does that float? I don't know. Let's see, anything relatively useless that we have that takes up some weight? What about firewood? I can always get more firewood. That's not a big deal. That should float. Yeah, I know physics. Now we can move again. Catch some salmon. Water's cool and refreshing, huh? So the meter down at the very bottom that you guys can see right there, that blue meter, that is our wetness meter. That is courtesy of Frostfall, which is probably the best weather mod out there, I think. And it's working in conjunction with a couple other different things. But yeah, so what that'll do, here if I go ahead and show it right here. Now those meters down at the bottom blue one is wetness, and above that is exposure. So our exposure is fine right now. We're actually as good as we can be. We're maximum warmth. Look at this beautiful city of Whiterun. Look at all those people going about their business. Love them. This is right one, but Whiterun, rather, is one of my favorite cities. I guess, you know, naturally you spend the most time here. Just because it's, you know, it's fairly easy to quest in Whiterun. Man, that is hard to say. Whiterun. W and an R sound. Maybe I'm just stupid. I don't know. Is the Gilder Green. But I spent a lot of time here during my testing and in everything. There's a couple mods going on here. As you can see, it looks a little bit different than it usually does.
Yes, sir.
These guys will sell, I believe this guy sells like Dragonborn stuff or just stuff from Solstheim and Morrowind. Yeah, he's got a couple things and also just generally food, it seems. Netch leather. I don't want any of that, but it's nice that you have it. I appreciate that you put it on sale, my friend. And this lady has, like, bakery items? Sweet roll stuff? Alright, ooh. This is a busy day in the market. Alright, well, first things first. We need to rest. What time is it right now? It is... Can't tell. Yeah, I'm hurting from the debuffs from being tired. Where's the clock? I can just do this. There we go. 5:57 p.m. Look at all these people in the market. What are you guys all doing here? Just hanging out? People hammering away, fixing stuff up? I really like the idea of having much more populated cities, just making these places feel a little bit more lived in, a little bit more populated, a little bit less empty, which is a problem that vanilla Skyrim obviously has. Ah, chicken. All right. Oh, that little girl's beating him up. You gonna go in that door, or you just gonna stand there and look at it? Oh, there she goes. Anyway, let's go ahead and have a nap. Let's see how that's affecting us. Exposure warm, that's fine. Amulet of Arcay, resist poison, severe fatigue. Base stamina and magicka reduced by about 60. Your movement speed is reduced by 15. Also learn skills 80% slower. Not ideal. Let's go ahead and let's have a sleep real fast.
Come on in.
All right.
Warm food, warm drinks, and warm beds.
Is that so? It's a nice place you got here, the Manor and Mare. Hey, buddy. Mercenary, change your name. There he goes. Sorarn Jorgensen. I really like that name mod just because, I don't know, it helps me kind of place a character to these generic NPCs.
How about chopping up some wood for the fires?
I'm good for the moment, I think. Do you have rooms available? Oh, I'm doing the, what's it called? This is enhanced bed stuff. I actually don't want to do that. I just need a place to stay. Wait, what? Just need a bed for the night. 50 gold. There it is. All right.
I'll show you to your room. Right.
Thank you.
Need anything else? Just let me know.
Before we take our nap, probably... you having some trouble there, Holda? You got it. I believe in you. You know, I know where my room is. You really don't have to show me. So I should be able to use this as storage now, the in-dresser. Also use this bathtub. Get a nice little bonus here. What does that do again? Bath, hygiene. Oh, perfect. Prices are 10% better. So what I was going to say is that we need to go and sell off some of the stuff that we have. I think would be a good idea before we rest for the night. So let's go do that. I can jump down from here. Oh, yeah. Imagine if you were just at an inn. Oh, look at her. She's still going. Oh, boy. I believe in you, Holda. You'll get it one day. What was I saying? I was saying, oh yeah, imagine if you were just chilling in the inn by the fire pit and then someone just jumped off of a second story balcony. It would be pretty crazy. Oh man, look at that sunset. Absolutely gorgeous. Oh, and you know what? Going and selling our stuff right now will give us also an opportunity to check out the inn when it's at night. Inns at night are really fun because there's a lot of people there and they're just hanging around and drinking, and it's just a good time for everybody. What's up, Bellathor?
Everything's for sale, my friend. Everything.
Oh, yeah?
Look.
All right, well. Now, Whiterun is kind of an exception to this, but the economy works a little bit differently in cities, really everywhere, but cities especially are generally more expensive, but they will also usually offer more for what you're selling. This also changes from city to city. Whiterun is a great city to buy and sell just because it's a trade city and it kind of reflects that. But certain places are not great for buying and selling respectively. For instance, Markarth is not a great place to buy things because everything's super expensive because everyone's rich there and so on and so forth. Anyway, let's go ahead and get some of our shit sold off. We don't need this elven battle axe. 50 measly gold for an elven weapon. Absolutely redonk. Bosmer boots is better than what we have now. My fur shoes are pretty garbage, really. They're not even boots, they're shoes. We'll hold on to the red. We don't need this shield. We don't need ragged boots or clothes. I'm just gonna go ahead and equip this right now, just so I have it. I'm gonna talk to him again.
Take a look.
It's for sale. Let's see, common clothes. No, that's his inventory. And then I have some gems I really don't need. Flawless emerald, 122, just absolute garbage. You really, I mean, this is a feature of Requiem, but it's something that's kind of enunciated in my own game, is, you know, if you want to make money, you really got to kind of invest in speechcraft or get a bunch of stuff, you know, because otherwise you're going to get shysted by these merchants who know how to haggle. So, I mean, not bad. We don't have a ton of money.
Remember, but I'll give you the best deals or die trying.
You are so creepy every time with this guy. But yes, I think our first goal should be to get a horse, because a horse really expands our opportunities in a lot of ways. For one, having a horse makes it a whole lot less dangerous to wander around, because we can get away from things, you know, instead of them. Because, like, most things are faster than us, or if we run out of stamina. Stamina is everything in Requiem, if you're not aware. So it's really important to manage, and having a horse does that. It's really, you know, helpful. The other thing is that having a horse means that we have additional carry weight, which means that we can haul back more loot from expeditions, so we can make money faster, and so on and so forth. Let's go ahead and let's go check out the inn. I'm gonna go ahead and, do I have anything to eat? You know, I have some raw meat. Let's go cook it up. What do you say? Go cook up some meat. Looks like everyone's going to the inn for the night. You guys are so slow queuing up in front of that door. I think they have a cooking pot in back. I'm gonna go use it.
Come on in.
Let's see.
Let me know if you need anything.
Let us see. Fire. Look at all these people in here. Here we go. Cooking spit. I should be able to cook this meat. Yes. I know how to use it. All right. Got a lot of meat. Nice cooked meat. That'll keep us full. And, it's about that time for the episode. But, let's go ahead and I'm gonna wait for an hour just so you guys can see how really packed these places get. Because it's pretty awesome. Give it a second. They'll start filtering in. Here they come. Hey, they're not old enough to be in here. Look at this fucking place. Oh, yeah?
The Forsworn a bunch of men. The Jarl of Markham should hunt down those troublemakers.
Look at this guy bouncing over here. You got it, bro. It'll take him a second to kind of filter out, because when you wait like that, they all kind of show up in the same spot. Look at this guy over here. Majik.
Do I need something?
You selling some cool stuff? What's so good? What do you got, boy? Just some food? Anatomy of a curse, huh? 749. That must have some really interesting stuff in it. Oh, okay. Shit. Oh, we're not a beast race. Dang it. We really should be focusing on stews for right now. Are you selling any stews by chance? The bartender might be, because we're going to need some of those. Cooked beef, cabbage soup. No beef stew. That's what I'm looking for. I would settle for vegetable stew. Vegetable soup? Yes! All right, so we're going to need this. Venison stew would also be great to have. Yeah, that's worth it for me. I'm gonna do that.
Swift hunting.
All right, look at all you guys all hanging out.
Good day.
Dude, are you serious right now? Get off that fire. Jeez, crazy. All right, well, I think we're gonna retire for the night. Go ahead and take a nap. What are you doing in my room? Get out of here, you freak. Ulfrith Warbear.
Watch it.
You watch it. You're literally in my room right now.
Be careful.
Alright, well, you guys can hang out on the balcony as long as you don't touch me while I'm asleep. Anyway, I think that'll do it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm really, really excited for this series. This is really just the beginning. It's really hard to demonstrate kind of everything that I feel like makes this special in one episode, but I promise if you stick with me, things will get even better as we go along. So, as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next episode.